Welcome to this brief guide on how to use Smart Canvas in Google Docs. In today's modern workplace environment, we tend to use a lot of different tools from different vendors. And ideally, we would love for these all to be able to work seamlessly together. And so today, I'm going to talk to you about a feature of Google Workspace that was introduced back in 2021 that's designed to help this integration. This particular feature is known as Smart Canvas. And over the last couple of years, Smart Canvas has grown into a feature-rich tool which helps me save time every single day. And so I'm going to show you how to activate it and what it can do. Inside Google Docs, to activate the Smart Canvas, you simply type in an at symbol, and this is going to give us a menu with a wide range of options, ranging from people in our contacts, through to smart chips for things such as the date, and then even building blocks for things such as meeting notes, email drafts, and more. In this example, I'm going to click on the date option, and this is going to give me a date picker where I can easily enter in any particular date and even a particular time if I want. And as you can see, I have a pill shape item here, and this is an actionable item, so I could easily hover over here and then quickly book a meeting. If you want to change your date format, you can do that through the settings cog shown here. And another example is one that I personally use almost every single day, and it's found in the building blocks category, and it's the option for the email draft. This allows me to draft up that super important email that I'm writing inside Google Docs, including the names of the people that are going to be in the to field, CC, and the subject line, as well as the email body. And when I'm ready to send it, I can simply click on the preview in Gmail button, which will shoot me over to Gmail with my email all typed up and ready to send. And so in our first two examples, we've shown off a tight integration with both Google Calendar and Gmail. But what about the files that we have in Google Drive? Well, that's next. So I can select my Yosemite National Park document that I was recently working on, and you'll see that it's been inserted natively into my document in a nice, easy to read format. And hovering over the name of the document, I can easily click to open it up in a new tab, or I can even copy the link if I wanted to put it into my clipboard. And I can even hover over it and select the option that says Open Preview in order to actually see a preview of this document inside the tab that I'm currently working in. This is great because I can reference another document without having to leave the document that I'm currently working on. And I still have the options to copy the link or open it in a new tab if I wish, or using the X button, I can close the preview down. And one of the other benefits of the Smart Canvas is I don't even necessarily have to use the menu for it. Say for instance, I want to paste in that link to the Yosemite National Park document. What I get is a prompt that lets me know if I wanted to, I could utilize the tab key on my keyboard, which would replace this long-winded link with the smart chip that we had originally for the Yosemite National Park document. And now, whilst I've gone over a few great examples of what you can do with Smart Canvas, they're all first party. What if I wanted to do the same thing and share this Figma project that I've been working on, all about improving customer retention? Normally, in order to do that, I would utilize the share menu inside of Figma, and then I would make sure that the permissions are correct, and then I would copy a link to this Figma project. Then I simply head back over to my Google Doc, and then we're going to go to a new line and we're going to paste in this link. But what you'll see is that unlike my Google Doc, I don't get an option to convert this over to a smart chip. It just pastes in like a regular link. But we can change this now through a brand new feature that's recently been added to Smart Canvas. Using the power of extensions, we can add third-party support into Smart Canvas directly. In order to install these extensions, you want to head to the Google Workspace Marketplace. And in our example, I've searched for Figma, which has brought me to the page for the Figma extension. In order to install it, I simply select that Install button. And after I've read the Terms of Service and Privacy Policy, I want to select the word that says Continue. I will get a prompt to sign in to my preferred Google account, and in this case I'm signing in to my demo account, and then I need to select the Allow button in order to give Figma permission to access my Google account. And in no time at all, the add-on will be successfully installed into my Workspace account. Select Done to close down that pop-up, and if I wanted to see what sorts of other applications already support this functionality, I can do a quick search for the term Smart Chip. Be sure to come back and check every couple of weeks as there are more tools being added every single day, and you'll see a lot of the common tools that you may already use inside your business, such as Atlassian or Tableau. And now to show off that brand new integration that we've just added on, I'm going to head to docs.new and create myself a brand new document. And then just like we did before on our previous document, I'm going to simply paste in the link to that Figma project that I've been working on. But now you'll see I have a brand new option where I can hit tab to replace that long-winded link with a Figma smart chip. And as you can see, it's already pulled in the title of my project of improving customer retention. And hovering over the hyperlink, I get a quick preview of what it looks like as well, and I even have options to copy that link if I needed to. Selecting the hyperlink will take me over to a brand new tab where my project will then load just like I'd expect. But over in my Google Doc, I get the added benefit of a much tidier appearance alongside all that great third-party integration. And that is how you use Smart Canvas in Google Docs. I hope you found these tips extremely useful and they save you plenty of time in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.